Hello, I'm Rick Love for Sun TV and the Sonoma International Film Festival's Filmmaker Interview Series. I have with us K. Rocco Shields, the writer and director of Love Is All You Need, a fascinating short film about a world in which straight and gay have been reversed, and that homosexual is normal, for lack of a better word, and heterosexual is not, and also coming at this material from a point of a young girl starting out. So tell me about where this idea and the inspiration of this project came from. The film is called Love Is All You Need.
Well, the film was inspired when everyone was in an uproar about teen bullying, and they still are. And there was all over the news, young kids were taking their lives at 11 years old, and everyone...
So during the It Gets Better, yes. Dan Savage's movement.
And no one could understand. Everyone's like, how is this even possible? And I thought, well, if the world was reversed, maybe people would understand. So this film is about more about bullying than it is setting up the frameworks of this like gay world, if you will. And it's showing bullying from a different lens. And by showing a little girl who's the protagonist, Ashley, being bullied because she is a hetero or because she likes a little boy at school, it brings awareness to a lot of prejudice that goes on in society today.
Right, and it exposes it in such a way that it makes it look ludicrous.
Exactly.
But at the same time, then you would have to say to yourself, and I'm sure this is your goal, well, how is it any more ludicrous than being reversed, heterosexuals picking on homosexuals. The choice of having the perspective be of a young girl and not a fully sexual man or woman in this situation, talk about that a little bit.
You know, it was really interesting. I actually, my first draft of the script, I wrote it for a little boy that was bullied, and I realized that our society is so used to seeing violence against men in general, or, you know, our society is very used to seeing violence. So I thought, wow, what better way to open people's eyes is to get a female protagonist who looks like the girl next door, who is relatable in every way, and show her being bullied as a boy would. So in one scene, she is like hit right across the face by an older guy, you know, and that happens to young boys all the time, but it brings awareness when you see it happening to a young girl.
And it makes it that much more terrifying.
It is.
Casting, you have young actress Lexi Benedetto playing Ashley, and mm-hmm. she really conveys that fear. Because the interesting thing about your story is a world askew, yet most people have been in a situation where they felt bullied, and she really conveys that terror, not just the terror of physical harm, but the terror of, and it's why that Dan Savage's It Gets Better is this idea that I live in this and it's never going to get better. I'm stuck in this cycle, and she really conveys that fear.
Yeah, you said that in the beginning it's almost absurd. My first screening, the audience kind of laughed in the first few scenes when you hear words like breeder and hetero. And then there's a point of no return in the fifth scene where you kind of get, you accept the world for what it is and you stop laughing because you realize that it is the real world that she lives in, and you really start to follow the journey of the protagonist, and the film takes her from birth till death.
And well, and Ms. Benedetto does a great job of conveying that fear, and we're really rooting for her, because you did cast she could be in television commercials, and she just has this pure all-American look. And the other thing that was interesting is you cast in an earlier scene a younger actress going back to a 6 or 7 year old. The wedding scene where the ring bearer looks across at the flower boy or whatever he is, that kind of sets this up as a starting from a purely innocent place.
Yeah, it's really important because there's so many discussions that could arise from this kind of topic. You know, some of nature versus nurture. Do you become gay? Is it something traumatic that happens to you? And that's what, and I really wanted to establish that Ashley comes from a place where her family is very normal. She has two picture-perfect parents. They love her. You know, everything is, you know, as it should be, but she knows she's different, and that's why I felt it important to set up from the beginning.
And how much involvement were the kids? I mean, I know you can shoot a movie where you kind of protect children from things. How clear were the kids on every scene and what's happening? Was everybody fully aware of the story and what was going on?
We felt it was necessary, me and my co-producer, Rachel, Rachel Diana, we felt it was necessary to bring all the kids, and we did an old-fashioned table read where we gathered them in with the parents and we read the script aloud before we shot it. And a lot of questions came up and the parents were there to kind of help us answer it. So all the kids were on the same page. The younger Ashley and the younger kids still haven't seen the final cut of the movie because of the ending. Mm-hmm. However, it's really exciting because we've joined forces with quite a few educational, LAUSD, GLSEN, educational networks, and they want to put it into schools across America. So we're going to shoot an alternate ending to make it a little bit more... a little bit better to be shown in schools.
A little more hope.
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. And what's even more exciting is it is becoming a feature film as well.
Oh, congratulations.
So, yeah, it's a dream come true.
It's a very rich story. And you can see that just from watching the trailer that there are these little scenes where you're putting the seed out there and you know you could spend a lot more time on this young woman in her complete stage and also kind of establishing this homosexual as normal world in media images and in, I mean, I can just picture what bus shelter ads would look like in that world and billboards and all of these different things. It would be very different.
There's quite a lot of that in the feature. The feature actually follows multiple storylines. So the short is the story of Ashley. The feature is the story of Ashley, but also other people that are being bullied in this world. I felt it would be very interesting to tell different stories from different perspectives with this lens. So we get into a lot of that, a lot of propaganda. We mm-hmm. have people that are modeled after people that are very against homosexuals in this world, but flipped around. So it's very interesting to see them.
With the religious perspective.
There is a religious character.
Which cannot be, in this issue, you cannot stay away from that because it's such an important part of religion and politics as well.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So how far along are you on the feature?
Well, we're actually at the most fun process. We are in casting right now, and it is gotten a bigger response than I ever could have even dreamed. We have been meeting with major A-list celebrities, lots of interest there. I can't give you the official, but
right.
I'm blown away by the talent and the people I'm meeting. I mean, it's amazing.
Well, your timing is fortuitous. I mean, it's the tragedies that led to the It Gets Better movement has kind of set this stage where, and it's not just outspoken gay celebrities, Neil Patrick Harris and Dan Savage and people like that, but it's a lot of people saying this has to stop. And these zero tolerance and I would imagine one of the things you'll be looking at in the film is kind of the way with texting and Facebook and a lot of this bullying is now not the face-to-face confrontational where at least there's some humanity involved.
Exactly. And on that note, this film was created because you can make a film about bullying, but in a way you're speaking to the choir. You know, there's been a few films made about little kids being bullied, but this film has been created in order to shed light to a huge audience, not just like a homosexual audience, which everyone gets it, you know?
Right.
So this is my chance as a filmmaker, which I'm hoping to open some eyes for people that wouldn't normally watch a movie like this because it is appealing to them.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sure casting would be a major part of that. You land a couple of these big actors, now you've crossed over into another realm.
Yeah, I'll tell you after we cut some of the exciting.
That is very exciting. The film is Love Is All You Need. It's screening as part of the Cycle of Life Shorts program. Next showing tomorrow at noon at the New Belgium Pub Women's Club, part of the Sonoma International Film Festival. K. Rocco Shields, thank you very much for coming and bringing this film to our festival. It's very interesting, and I look forward to seeing where it ends up next.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.